So I'll watch Squid Game. By the way, if you really watch the dub version of that, you're actually a menace to society.
Stop calling me babe, an old man, huh?
But it was a great show, you know? Suspenseful, great characters, justice for my boy Ali. Just all around, borderline, perfect show. Until literally the last 10 seconds. I'm thinking, oh, okay, so the guy's gonna get on the plane, the game is gonna go on. That's just the dark, harsh reality of our world, man. And then last second, they got him turning around like he's John Wick. What, so he's gonna take down the games? This man barely got out alive the last time. Now the show is so big, they basically have to do a season 2. It's not even a choice at this point, like it's required for Netflix. It's their biggest show ever. I'm honestly not ready for them to have to try to bring back this girl just because she's so loved on the internet. She was amazing, but do we really need that for the story? What they really need to do is bring back this queen right here. But it got me thinking about just how many shows felt required to have to go past their prime or just their limit in general. Like, how do they decide that? Like, if the audience is still wanting more, how do you just stop the money from coming in just because you know it's better for the story? Do you make more money now, or do you get to be considered one of the greatest ever as time goes on? It's not an easy decision to make. There's a lot of factors in there. People want WandaVision to be renewed for a season 2. What is she gonna do? She's gonna freak out again and get trapped in more sitcoms? I mean, are you dumb? You want her to go through more grief? Leave her alone. If they had a Squid Game 2, I wouldn't mind. I would like to see them play backgammon or tag or pin the tail on the... I don't know, I never went outside as a kid. But it's gonna be interesting if they can actually do anything to add to the story when so much of it was great because of that mystery. I don't want it to turn into Hunger Games where the whole plot is taking down the games, even though the games themselves are the most interesting part of the whole story. I'm a big believer in never ever quitting. But sometimes you have to know when to quit. There's only a couple of shows that stopped right when they should have. Most of them just keep going till they have a slow, painful death. Or they're like Game of Thrones and they end too early. That one was just unheard of, because I've never seen a show end too early on purpose. Usually shows either go on for too long or they get canceled before they get a chance to finish it. By the way, when I say canceled in this video, I don't mean like SpongeBob got canceled, you know, you got caught saying the N-word or something. No, I mean the network actually decided to take the show off the air. He didn't call me and Rick and Morty announced that there's gonna be like 70 more episodes before they even made 30 total episodes. Why not do 10 at a time? Or like, what if they go all the way to 40 and then they don't wanna do it anymore? Like 70, just announcing 7 seasons at once, it's just ridiculous. One of my favorite shows of all time was this show called 24, which is low key underrated at this point. Not enough people talk about it. But every season would take place over the course of one day. There were 24 episodes. Each episode was an hour long. So the season would literally start at 12 a.m. midnight. 6 episodes later, it will be 6 a.m. in the world of the show. Like, the sun would literally just start rising for the first time. Everything is in real time. Honestly, it's one of the craziest, most stressful shows ever. I watched and loved the entire thing, but oh my gosh, they made it keep going on forever. Jack Bauer is the most abused character in the history of television. They literally never let this man just have a good ending. Like, he's never been allowed to just rest because they have to make another season. Every season ends with a cliffhanger. He's something terrible has happened to him. He's going into hiding or something. To this day, he's not had an ending to his story. Just let the man chill in peace, please. Somebody end his suffering. The Office is one of the biggest offenders of this. I remember being a kid, not even watching The Office, and just seeing a promo for a next episode where they're like, this is the new guy. This is the guy replacing Steve Carell, everybody. Yeah. And I remember being a kid like, that's the guy you got? Like, I didn't even watch the show and I was like, this guy is not.
Trust me, you're not that guy.
This guy looks annoying. Come to know, I watched it 10 years later, I was right. It pissed me off even as a kid. I was like, what are y'all thinking? When I finally got to watch the show in college, I remember just binging it and the amount of times I would laugh out loud during the earlier seasons, having to go back and rewind, watching parts literally 3 times, just dying laughing. Then my laughter slowly fading out over the course of the series. And by the end, watching entire episodes just with a straight face, like, doing the little nose air thing. This is not what I've come to expect from The Office, man. Dwight carried the entire final seasons on his back. They're watchable, but the amount of random, forgettable characters that they keep adding just makes it so much worse than before. Still one of the greatest comedy shows of all time, but if they had just stopped it right when Steve Carell left, would it be, like, could you just comfortably say top 2? Do those final seasons keep it from that conversation just because it has seasons that are not good? Just because it peters out instead of just ending with a bang? Sitcoms like The Office that go on for so long have to drag out that will they, won't they relationship. Jim and Pam, Ross and Rachel, me and you. That's right, this YouTube channel has a will they, won't they relationship. Me and you have been talking and just watching each other for so long, when are we just gonna kiss already?
All right. I guess not.
But all these relationships in these shows have to last multiple seasons. But I actually completely understand this because the will they, won't they is the best part because as soon as they get together, it's boring. It's so boring that The Office just had to start coming up with random conflicts for Jim and Pam to have. Like, yo, camera guy,
Who, me?
Yeah, you. We're gonna need you to flirt with Pam a little bit, alright? Create a little drama in there, you know what I mean?
Trust me, I'm way ahead of you.
No!
I just...
You homewrecker! She's with the love of her life, you idiot!
You just told
that
me...
was a test! You're fired! What? Ridiculous. A show like Lost had the will they, won't they, and then also a will they, won't they relationship. A little love triangle thing going on. By season 5, I was like, enough! Just choose one of these white men! Other than that, the show is still top 5 all time, even though people are not big fans of that ending. But one thing I can say is the characters were good all the way through for me. On the other hand, I feel like people are gonna get mad at me for this, but after the first season of Stranger Things, what has even really happened in that show? Like, they've been cool, but... what really has happened? Like, they're fighting the same monster? Just move. Move your town. It's weird because I didn't not enjoy watching the second and third seasons. I actually enjoyed them while I was watching them. And then I think back on it a week later and I forgot everything that happened. By season 5, these kids are going to be old enough to have kids of their own.
That's the spinoff right there. That's the spinoff right there, boys.
If we're talking about a show that went out on top, one of my favorite sitcoms ever, Seinfeld. Better than The Office, better than Friends, better than whatever else you're thinking of right now. But it had some of its best episodes in its 7th, 8th, and 9th seasons. They knew if they went to 10, they might be overdoing it, so they just stopped. And I love that idea of going out on top, leaving the audience wanting more, instead of giving them so much they get sick of it, and sick of you. That's why this video is over. No, it's not. Breaking Bad is probably my top 2 shows of all time. And that's because they stopped it at a perfect time instead of dragging it out for another 3 seasons just because it was popular. They didn't do the thing where somebody just starts acting out a character for the entire season because the writers ran out of things to do with them. That takes you out of the show. It reminds you, oh, these characters are being written by people in the real world who might not know what they're doing. It's like you can feel the show falling apart as they keep doing more and more seasons. One of the worst cases of this was this show called Heroes. This was honestly one of the worst shows I ever forced myself to sit all the way through. It was basically just off-brand X-Men. This is back in the day before we were getting a lot of superhero content, all right? There weren't enough superhero TV live-action shows. Now we got literally like 5 at a time. Back then, I was starving, okay? The first season was fine. I was like, all right, this needs to go somewhere fast. It didn't. The second season was particularly bad, and then I find out 10 years later there was a writer's strike going on the whole time, and that's why. They should have honestly put that at the beginning of every episode. Hey guys, by the way, we're on a writer's strike, so this is probably gonna be garbage. Don't blame us, okay? We're on strike right now. I mean, what can I say? But hey, I support the writers on strike here. I just wish somebody would have told me about it so I could go on strike by not watching this show. And I watched it all the way to the end just to see what would happen. And then the show just ends with a cliffhanger and never gets resolved. That's why I love a limited series. Just give me 8 episodes of a story. Boom. She's a queen playing chess. There's a gambit. It's over now. I don't know what happens in that show. I haven't seen it. But some shows are able to last longer just because they ask less of us as viewers. Shows like Family Guy, The Simpsons, South Park. They can low-key go on forever and no one will really mind. Even though their best episodes are behind them. It's not the type of show with intricate character arcs where you have to start at the beginning and watch all the way through to get the full experience. They will make Grey's Anatomy forever because there will always be people that need to go to the doctor. Sesame Street can go on forever because these kids are always going to be dumb and not even know how to count. I mean, can you believe it? How do you expect to get ahead in this world, Timmy. I haven't even seen The Walking Dead past the first season, but all I hear about is how is this show still on? This is why I respect the British, man. Their seasons of TV are like 3 episodes each, 2-3 seasons max. They're in and out. They don't overstay their welcome. Plus, they eat a food called steak and kidney pudding. I just gotta respect anybody that can do that. Different comparison, but Lauryn Hill is forever seen as one of the greatest ever because she dropped one of the greatest albums of all time and then just stopped. We'll never know if she can do that again. And maybe that's okay. That legacy is cemented forever. That's just so interesting to me. So yeah, I wonder if they do a Squid Game 2, what's it gonna be like? I hope they figure out a way to not make it feel pointless. What do you think? What's a show or movie or franchise that's the worst offender of this that needs to just end? Or something that ended perfectly that you feel like went out on top? Let me know in the comments down below. All right, now let's end the video before the writers of the channel give me a random love interest or something.
Excuse me? Is this the right place?